Early speculation places blame on terrorist Osama bin Laden.
Bin Laden.
Osama bin Laden.
Bin Laden.
Osama bin Laden.
Bin Laden.
Bin Laden.
Supposedly, a CNN reporter found Osama bin Laden, took a television camera crew with him, went into Osama bin Laden's hideout, interviewed him and his top leadership, and he came out and told everybody, within 3 weeks, Osama bin Laden is going to attack the United States. Now, don't you think that's kind of strange, folks? You see, because the largest intelligence apparatus in the world, with the biggest budget in the history of the world, has been looking for Osama bin Laden for years and years and years, and can't find him. Some doofus jerk-off reporter with a camera crew waltzes right into his hideout and interviews him. And I'm telling you, be prepared for a major attack. But it won't be Osama bin Laden. It will be those behind the New World Order. I wonder what Osama bin Laden's targets are supposed to be. And if they don't, you know, if this doesn't materialize in the next 2 or 3 weeks, it will eventually materialize, because they haven't succeeded in getting the guns out of the hands of the American people, nor have they succeeded in taking our freedoms away. And so I can tell you with a certainty, they must do something terrible in order to stop this backlash and regain the sympathy of the mass herds of sheeple out there.
I can hear you! I can hear you, the rest of the world hears you, and the people...
Our war on terror begins with Al-Qaeda, but it does not end there. It will not end until every terrorist group of global reach has been found, stopped, and defeated. Americans are asking, why do they hate us? They hate what they see right here in this chamber, a democratically elected government. Their leaders are self-appointed. They hate our freedoms, our freedom of religion, our freedom of speech, our freedom to vote and assemble and disagree with each other. They want to overthrow existing governments in many Muslim countries, such as Egypt, Saudi Arabia, and Jordan. They want to drive Israel out of the Middle East. They want to drive Christians and Jews out of vast regions of Asia and Africa. These terrorists kill not merely to end lives, but to disrupt and end a way of life. With every atrocity, they hope that America grows fearful, retreating from the world and forsaking our friends. They stand against us. because we stand in their way. We're not deceived by their pretenses to piety. We have seen their kind before. They are the heirs of all the murderous ideologies of the 20th century. By sacrificing human life to serve their radical visions, by abandoning every value except the will to power, they follow in the path of fascism, Nazism, and totalitarianism. And they will follow that path all the way to where it ends, in history's unmarked grave of discarded lies. We will direct every resource at our command, every means of diplomacy, every tool of intelligence, every instrument of law enforcement, every financial influence, and every necessary weapon of war. Either you are with us, or you are with the terrorists.
I met Rockefeller through a female attorney I knew, who called me up one day and said, one of the Rockefellers would like to meet you. I made a video called Mad as Hell, and he'd seen the video and wanted to meet me, and knew I was running for governor of Nevada. Well, sure, I'd love to meet him. And I met him, and I liked him, and he was a very, very smart man, and we used to talk and share ideas and thoughts, and he's the one who told me 11 months before 9/11 ever happened that there was going to be an event. Never told me what the event was going to be, but there was going to be an event, and out of that event, we were going to invade Afghanistan to run pipelines from the Caspian Sea. We were going to invade Iraq, you know, to take over the oil fields, establish a base in the Middle East, and make it all part of the New World Order. And we go after Chavez in Venezuela. And sure enough, later 9/11 happened. I mean, why do you think 9/11 happened and then nothing's happened since then? Do you think that our security is so great here that these people who pulled off 9/11 who were able to, can't knock down another plane? Come on, it's ridiculous. 9/11 was done by people in our own government and our own banking system to perpetuate the fear of the American people into subordinating themselves to anything the government wants them to do. That's what it's about, and to create this war, this endless war on terror. This whole war on terror is a fraud. It's a farce.
Let's rewind back to Building 7. Some people will claim the combination of structural damage and fire is what brought it down. The picture that NIST likes to use conflicts with other pictures concerning the damage of Building 7. If they're going to claim structural damage along with fires was the cause, why didn't this building collapse after the Oklahoma City bombing? Its damage was a lot greater than Building 7's. A lot of people don't realize that FEMA and NIST withdrew the claim that fires and structural damage were the cause of the collapse. First they said fuel oil tanks caused it, then they retracted that theory. They then said the North Tower's debris knocked down the central support pillar, then they retracted that. They said it was structurally built incorrectly, then they retracted that. Now they're saying they don't know.
The Red Cross rep was like, he goes over and he says, well, you got to stay behind this line because they're thinking about bringing the building down. They didn't say what building. They just said bringing a building down. So we're like, okay, you know, we'll take their word before it. You know, we'll stay behind the line. And he went over and he talked to one of the, through all the commotion, he goes over and he asked one of the Red Cross, or one of the firefighters, what was going on. I guess, I don't know if he got an answer or not. He came back over with his hand over the radio, and what sounded like a countdown. And at the last few seconds, he took his hand off, and you heard 3, 2, 1, and he was just saying, just run for your life, just run for your life. And then it was like another 2, 3 seconds, you heard explosions. Like, boom! It's like a distinct sound. It's not like when compression, like boom, 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 boom. Like floors that were dropping and collapsing. This was boom! And like you felt a rumble in the ground, like almost like you wanted to grab onto something. That, to me, I knew that was an explosion. There was no doubt in my mind.